Hello students, welcome to the session continuation of granulomatous inflammation. Earlier we were talking about primary tuberculosis, now we talk about secondary tuberculosis. The infection of an individual who has been previously infected or sensitized is called secondary or post primary or reinfection or chronic tuberculosis. Endogenous source or exogenous source may contribute for the secondary tuberculosis. The lesions in secondary pulmonary tuberculosis usually begin as 1 to 2 centimeter apical area of consolidation of the lung, which may in time develop a small area of central caseation, necrosis and peripheral fibrosis. It occurs by hematogenous spread of an infection from primary complex to the apex of the affected lung, where the oxygen tension is high and favorable for growth of an aerobic tubercle bacilli. Fate of secondary pulmonary tuberculosis: the lesions may heal with fibrous scarring and calcification. The lesions may coalesce together to form larger area of tuberculous pneumonia and produce progressive secondary pulmonary tuberculosis with the following pulmonary and extrapulmonary involvements: fibrocaceous tuberculosis, tuberculous caseous pneumonia, miliary tuberculosis. Secondary pulmonary tuberculosis: the upper parts of both lungs are riddled with gray white areas of caseation and multiple areas of softening and cavitation. Primary or Ganz complex: pulmonary tuberculosis is the pattern seen with initial infection with tuberculosis in children. Reactivation or secondary tuberculosis is more typically seen in adults. Miliary tuberculosis: there will be a millet seed-like appearance on a chest x-ray and even the cut surface of the lung. Clinical features are productive cough with hemoptysis, that means blood tinged with the sputum, pulmonary effusion, dyspnea, orthopnea. So pulmonary effusion, the fluid collection in the pleural cavity, and dyspnea, that is difficulties breathless breathing, orthopnea, during any ambulatory movements there will be a breathlessness. Chest x-ray may show typical apical changes like pleural effusion, nodularity and miliary or diffuse infiltrates in the lung parenchyma. Systemic features mainly such as fever, night sweats, fatigue, loss of weight and appetite. One more granulomatous inflammation, that is leprosy, are also called as Hansen's disease. Leprosy or Hansen's disease. It is a chronic non-fatal infectious disease affecting mainly the cooler parts of the body such as the skin, mouth, respiratory tract, eyes, peripheral nerves, superficial lymph nodes and testes. It's mainly caused by Mycobacterium leprae, but it is less acid fast. The organisms in tissues appear as compact rounded masses like goby, are arranged in parallel fashion like cigarettes in pack. Mycobacterium leprae is an acid fast obligate intracellular organism that grows very poorly in culture. It proliferates best at 32 to 34 degree Celsius, the temperature of the human skin. Like Mycobacterium tuberculosis, the Mycobacterium leprae secretes no toxins and its virulence is based on properties of its cell wall. The cell wall is similar enough to that of Mycobacterium tuberculosis that immunization with BCG confirms some protection. Acid fast or Zn staining, that means Zill and Nelson staining, methanin silver and molecular methods, even IgM antibodies, these are the main staining properties can be done for Mycobacterium leprae. Mode of transmission: incubation period between first exposure and appearance of signs of disease varies from 2 to 20 years with direct contact. Materno-fetal transmission across the placenta, transmission from milk of leprosy patient to infants. Lepromin test, that is the intradermal injection of lepromine, an antigenic extract of Mycobacterium leprae, reveals delayed hypersensitivity reaction in patients of tuberculoid leprosy, an early positive reaction appearing as an indurated area in 24 to 48 hours is called as Fernandez reaction. A delayed granulomatous lesion appearing after 3 to 4 weeks is called Mitsuda reaction. Patients of lepromatous leprosy are negative by the lepromin test. People with the less severe form, that is tuberculoid leprosy, have dry scaly skin, lesions that lack sensation. They often have asymmetric involvement of large peripheral nerves. The more severe form is lepromatous leprosy. This includes symmetric skin thickening and nodules. This is also called anergic leprosy because of unresponsiveness of the host immune system. Cooler areas of skin, including the earlobes, feet, are more severely affected than warmer areas such as the axilla and groin. In lepromatous leprosy, widespread invasion of the mycobacteria into Schwann cells and into endoneural and perineural macrophages damages the peripheral nervous system. In advanced cases of lepromatous leprosy, Mycobacterium leprae is present in sputum and blood. People can also have intermediate form of disease that is called as borderline leprosy. Morphological features. Tuberculoid leprosy begins with localized flat red skin lesions that enlarge and develop irregular shapes with indurated, elevated, hyperpigmented margins and depressed pale centers, that is called central healing. Nerve degeneration causes skin anesthesia and skin and muscle atrophy that render the person liable to trauma of the affected parts, leading to the development of chronic skin ulcers. Thank you.